It's been 5 years of growing. There were some tests and you know it. We faced the best and the worst days. We faced the best and the worst of it. But you stood by me no matter what the circumstance. And when you're next to me I feel like Superman. I know God made you for me. Yeah. And if I could have my way I'd start every day waking up next to you, lady. And when the day is done and the sun goes down, with you I'd want to lay my head. And baby, if the rain starts to fall outside of your window, it's alright, cause I'm on the next side of your pillow. I spoke to God and the signs he we'd never know unless we start. Baby, let's start, yeah. Marry me.
Will you marry me?
Will you marry me, girl? Yeah, yeah.
I just wanna know, will you marry me?
Girl, yeah. Marry me, girl.
Will you marry me?
Marry me.
Will you marry me?
Da, da, da. Just say yes, just say yes, girl. I'm down on one knee, girl. I just have one question.
Will you marry me?
Will you marry me?
Kathy.
Precious than a rose, my girl. You just wanna know, will you marry me? Marry me.
Will you marry me?
It's been 5 years of growing. There were some tests and you know it. We faced the best and the worst days.
We faced the best and the worst of it.
But you stood by me no matter what the circumstance. And when you're next to me, I feel like Superman. I know God made you for me. Yeah. And if I could have my way, I'd start every day waking up next to you, lady. And when the day is done and the sun goes down, with you I'd want to lay my head. And baby, if the rain starts to fall outside of your window, it's alright, cause I'm on the next side of your pillow. I spoke to God and the signs he gave clear. Will you marry me? Girl, I know we're not perfect, and life sometimes gets hard, but I know we're gonna make it. If it's me and you and God, life's journey is uncertain. We never know unless we start. Baby, let's start, yeah. Marry me. Just say yes, just say yes, girl. I'm down on one knee, girl. I just have one question.
Will you marry me?
Will you marry me?
Kathy.
precious than a rose. My girl, you're beautiful. Your soul is timeless, and your heart is made of gold. I'm glad I'm in your world. And if I could have my way, I would start every day waking up next to you, lady. And when the day is done and the sun goes down, with you I'd want to lay my head. And baby, if the rain starts to fall outside of your window, it's alright, cause I'm on the next side of your pillow. I spoke to God, and the signs he gave were clear. So will you marry me, baby? Marry me, girl, or girl, no, no. Marry me, yeah, lady. Marry me, I just wanna know. Will you marry me, yeah? Marry me. It's been 5 years of growing. There were some tests and you know it. We faced the best and the worst days. The day is done and the sun goes down, with you I'd want to lay my head. And baby, if the rain starts to fall outside of your window, it's alright, cause I'm on the next side of your pillow. I spoke to God and the signs he gave were clear. Will you marry me? Girl, I know we're not perfect, and life sometimes gets hard, but I know we're gonna make it. If it's me and you and God, life's journey is uncertain. We never know unless we start. Baby, let's start, yeah. Marry me. Just say yes, just say yes, girl. I'm down on one knee, girl. I just have one question. Will you marry me? Will you marry me? Than a rose, my girl, you're beautiful. Your soul is timeless, and your heart is made of gold. I'm glad I'm in your world. And if I could have my way, I would start every day waking up next to you, lady. And when the day is done and the sun goes down, with you I'd want to lay my head. And baby, if the rain starts to fall outside of your window, it's alright, cause I'm on the next side of your pillow. I spoke to God, and the signs he gave were clear. So will you marry me, baby? Marry me, girl, or girl, no, no.
It's been 5 years of growing. There were some tests and you know it. We faced the best and the worst days. We faced the best and the worst of it. But you stood by me no matter what the circumstance. And when you're next to me I feel like Superman. I know God made you for me. Yeah. And if I could have my way I'd start every day waking up next to you, lady. And when the day is done and the sun goes down, with you I'd want to lay my head. And baby, if the rain starts to fall outside of your window, it's alright, cause I'm on the next side of your pillow. I spoke to God and the signs he gave clear. Will you marry me? And life sometimes gets hard, but I know we're gonna make it. If it's me and you and God, life's journey is uncertain. We never know unless we start. Baby, let's start, yeah. Marry me. Just say yes, girl. I'm down on one knee, girl. I just have one question. Will you marry me? Will you marry me?
Kathy. Okay, okay, okay. Now, have you ever been with a player? Take you downtown where they treat me like the mayor. Take you to the crib where you take it upstairs.
What's upstairs?
Shit, I'ma show you later. Don't need a spatula, everything catered. Extra flavor. Go ahead, sprinkle some truffles on your mashed potatoes. I'm trying to love you.
Let me invite everyone to please stand. All right, ladies and gentlemen, thank you very much for being here. And of course, this is a grand occasion, one that oftentimes brings laughter, smiling, and of course, there are sometimes tears. But thank you very much for being here. And let me take the opportunity to welcome all of you and to congratulate these two wonderful people. I'm going to give you an exercise shortly, but in the meantime, let's bow our heads, we pray, and then I will allow some persons to have their seats. Father in heaven, today is a grand day. Today is the day that these two wonderful young people have decided to give their hearts to each other officially. And now I pray that you will be with us as we have this brief but important ceremony. In Jesus' name, amen. All right, I understand that you all would be allowed to sit. Have a good one. Not you, not you, not you. Yes, both of you, sure. Thank you very much. All right, so you can have your seats, feel free. I'd just like, while we sort out things, I'd just like to do a check, a quick check, because the Bible does talk about wives being helpmeets, and husbands, wives also being submitted, submitting to their husbands. So I want you to just look at each other. Yeah, take a good look. Now, this is an opportunity for deposits to be made. So let's just check some things out, because if we're not ready for this, if you don't answer these questions appropriately, we'll forget about this whole thing. You all didn't expect that. So here goes. Geovanni, as you saw Kharyse coming down the walkway, the pathway, what were your thoughts? This is about an opportunity for making appropriate deposits, I understand.
I'm sorry I made her wait.
You are sorry you made her wait? Ladies and gentlemen, we just got some information there that probably she made the proposal. So thank you very, very much. So you're happy that this day has come, nonetheless. Beautiful. What do you think about this young man? Does he seem to be the person? Are you convinced that this is the individual that you are comfortable respecting? You can respect his judgment, respect everything about him. Talk to us.
Yes, I had 8 years of practice.
She just confirmed it. Probably she proposed in the second year and waited 6 years. Thank you very much. You can look this way now. So, today we are here, and I'm very happy that these two seem to be very comfortable with one another. I've had the opportunity on quite a few occasions to be in their lives. Geovanni would not like this to be expressed, but he was my student, and we had a hard time. We had a hard time in that class. I am surprised that, having been his lecturer, I was trying to hide this, but since he has revealed it, yes, he failed that course. I remember him asking me, almost begging me, and I said, no. I'm actually surprised that he would ask me to officiate here. I thought I would have been his number one enemy, but he has forgiven or recognized that he deserved it back then, and here we are. All right. So that's Geovanni. Geovanni is also my colleague, and we have shared quite a few thoughts together. So we share great things. Kharyse, on the other hand, I only found out about Kharyse when she, to a large degree, decided to get baptized. And on that day, I remember Geovanni being there, and I was wondering, why are you here? You know, and then I found out that there was something cooking, and I thought that I probably should allow him to come and do the baptism. You know, that would have been a wonderful experience. I've counseled them, and here they are. So, we have been on this journey together, all right? So, there are a few things I'd like to share with you. I'm going to share some things from my personal experience. These are stories that I hope would help you on your journey. And possibly, in my view, a wedding is not just for the bride and groom, but rather for all of those who are here. So there may be some thoughts, some things that persons may learn from what I'm going to say. So let's just share those things. I'm going to share three things. One, I have concluded, in fact, even before marriage, that if I were to marry myself, I would never do it. I suspect many of us here would conclude the same. What is interesting, though, is that we still want others to marry us. In other words, we can't deal with our own faults, but we want others to deal with our faults and accept them and possibly excuse them. I want you to remember that. If you do not remember that now and onwards, wait a while until your parents get grandchildren through you. In other words, wait a while until you get children. And oftentimes, what happens is that your children, you see something, a streak, walk the complete package in your child. You see yourself, and you want to beat the living daylights out. Sorry, you want to, you, praise the Lord. you want to deal with that child. And then you remember, but that's me. So if you have to beat that child, you have to beat yourself too. God has a way of reminding us that there are many things in our lives that we don't like, but we want others to excuse. I want us to keep that in mind as you go forward. Don't excuse your imperfections. Acknowledge them. And yes, try to work together to fix those. My wife didn't know that I was going to bring this up, but I'm going to do it nonetheless. My risk. My wife has grown significantly. So there you go. I'm making some deposits right now. She has grown significantly. Early in the marriage, she was critical of the many negative things that I, negative traits I have. Many. She's watching me seriously, so I'll look this direction. But over the last few years, I have seen where she has been very diplomatic and tactful. For example, some things maybe gentlemen oftentimes know about this. Some things may be left in places they should not be left. You could apply that however you want. It could be the pot, it could be the clothes, it could be the shoe, it could be the socks, it could be you do it. And she would now say, Roger, you know, I've discovered this thing left here. I'm sure you didn't want to leave it here. Let me help you. I'll bring it closer to you or something like that, and you can put it in the right place. I'm sure. Could find those nice ways. And if you can do it nicer, by all means. You know, but she has improved significantly. Now, second thing. Take your time. My father-in-law taught me in college. My mother-in-law had no dreams, no aspirations for her daughter to marry a pastor. None. Absolutely none. In fact, it probably was a nightmare when it came to her attention that her daughter was interested, her only child was interested in a pastor. After all, pastors go and better themselves and they leave the wives behind. The wives don't go and study and that sort of thing. That was the idea. And her dream for her daughter was to fly the world. And pastors, of course, can't afford that. How dare you go and marry a pastor? I knew that that would have been an uphill task. So what did I do? I spoke to my teacher, that's her father. I approached him first. I told him that I am aware that there are some challenges. My mother-in-law did not want me as a son-in-law. I don't know why. Such a handsome young man, not so? God bless you. She didn't. My father-in-law said, no problem, you can have her. And don't worry about my wife. Here it is. Here the classic father-in-law. He said, I'll take care of that. Now, I'm the only son that my mother-in-law has. And she has grown to see that all pastors are not stereotyped as she had it. That's number two. Number three, which is the final point. the final experience. And this one is very real to both of you. Well, very applicable to both of you. Very applicable. Because I actually see something interesting. I see that we're going to finish just now. You're Trini. You're Jamaican. Jamaican Trini. Jamaican. Okay, no problem. I know I have had some terrible experience. By the way, any Jamaicans here? Any other Jamaicans here? Okay, so I have to be careful. I have to be careful. But let me say, I'm going to be very balanced here. Thanks. We'll talk afterwards, right? I have had some very terrible experiences, some with Jamaicans. Yes, I have. I can think of one that is going on right now. Not between us. Right? There was some years, 20-something years ago, a certain young lady and a young man, a Trini young lady and a Jamaican young man, both went to UE St. Augustine, came home, a home in Arima. Yes, I remember. The family was gathered together. The Trini family was gathered together. This was the opportunity. This was the time the Jamaican guy would say, hey, I'm interested in the Trini girl. I sat down as a witness because I was one of the Trini girl's siblings. The Trini girl, by the way, is my big sister. I fall right next to her, right after her, and then my brother. And I do remember the conversation going quite nicely. My parents were quite open and everything. And then hear this. My mother asked a significant question. The question was, by the way, my mother's dream was always that all her children will live around her. So we'll build houses. So my mother asked the question, now tell me where you're going to live. And my sister answered the question, we're heading to Jamaica. I remember that whole meeting. It became tense and heavy. My mother said nothing else for the night. My father tried to calm it down, and he kept the conversation going. I concluded this. Jamaicans, listen to this. It's not all bad. I have lived to confess. In fact, I never had a problem with it. But there is evidence that my brother-in-law is one of the best brothers-in-law the only one that I could have, a Jamaican of the highest class and order, highest ilk. I didn't say it to you, but he said we're welcome. But I suspect, having known Geovanni for a long while, and having heard stories of Geovanni leaving late in the night to come and pick you up, you must feel real special. Sorry, spoilt. More like it. That's right. So I'm saying that there is quality here. And I believe that this is an opportunity for us to ensure. Because my brother-in-law taught me something. Never judge Jamaicans or categorize them just like that. They are some really positive individuals. And I suspect those that venture to come to Trini, all you're real nice. And? That is what we're talking about. That's what we're talking about. So today, I'm saying to you, well done, good choice. Well done, good choice. And now it's time for the families. And marriage, somebody once said, this is a negative way of saying it, a collision of two backgrounds. But it's a real way of doing things, because any married person here would tell you, marriage ain't easy. Come out smiling, but you're eating up. And that sort of thing, right? So you will have your challenges, but I'm sure if you learn to manage them, you'll do just fine. Congratulations. Ladies and gentlemen, I hope that you gleaned some stuff there from things that were said. We're gonna go into the legal aspect now. So we're getting ready for the vows. Listen up. One of the things that we did in our marriage, in our wedding, or pre-wedding, was to fine-tune the guest list. Yeah. So, individuals who may create a stir and problems, they're just not invited, right? But sometimes they slip in. So I need to ask this question, right? So for just in case there's anybody that was not invited that got in here, let's just sort that out. You ready? Anybody here knows any reason why these two should not be joined together? This is your opportunity to speak. Because henceforth, after the vows, the legal aspects, that's it. Anybody? Yes? Yeah? No. Don't stress. Don't stress at all. Don't stress. Let not your heart be troubled. All right. So it seems as though we can move forward. So we're gonna do the vows. That's all right. Okay, who are the ones that give this young man and this young lady to be joined together? I'd like you to please come stand next to the one you're giving. Come right along, please. I'm looking to see Kharyse's resemblance. Kharyse's, oh boy, wrong name. Don't go that route, sorry, Kharyse. Very well. So, yeah, that's daddy, good, got it. So, here goes. I want you both to face each other. You'd want to take this. Yes, you all will just stand in solidarity. That's what you're doing. Okay, so you're going to repeat after me. I have to make sure that I get the exact name here. I, Giovanni Anthony John Keith.
I, Giovanni Anthony John Keith.
Take you, Kharyse Alexis Fonset.
Take you, Kharyse Alexis Fonset.
I caused that, right? To be my lawful wedded wife.
To be my lawful wedded wife.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
Watching? You all watching in each other's eyes? Come on, hold it. Nice. Very good. From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better.
For better.
For worse.
And better.
For worse.
And better.
Excellent. So you're going to learn from the worst experiences and become better. Beautiful. For richer.
For richer.
For poorer.
And richer.
Okay, so you're also going to learn from that. From these guys are not living in the real world. but I'm thankful I know what they mean, because we talked about that. In sickness?
In sickness.
Oh, you can deal with that. In health.
She's a doctor.
Okay, no problem.
In health.
In health. Until death do us part.
Until death do us part.
I will love.
I will love.
And honor you.
And honor you.
All the days of my life.
All the days of my life.
Beautiful. Kharyse, how do you feel about that?
Good.
You felt good with him not listening and following what I said?
ETS. ETS.
Oh, okay. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Mm-hmm. I, Kharyse Alexis Fonset.
I, Kharyse Alexis Fonset.
Take you, Geovanni Anthony John Keith.
Take you, Geovanni Anthony John Keith.
To be my lawfully wedded husband.
To be my lawfully wedded husband.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
Listen to me carefully. For better.
For better.
For worse.
For bad. For worse.
Well, you got some sense. For richer.
For richer.
For poorer.
For poorer.
Nice. In sickness.
In sickness.
And in health.
And in health.
Till death do us part.
Till death do us part.
I will love.
I will love.
And honor you.
And honor you.
All days of my life.
All the days of my life.
Very well. This is where the parents will get involved as well. Won't you just bring your hands together, please? All the hands together. All right? I want to make sure that you get a good shot. You probably will have to... He'll get you. Come in front there. You'll come... Come in front. More to the side there, and just put your hand here, please. Right? Put your hand here. Very well. Yep. Yeah. Anywhere you want to put it. Beautiful. All right. This is actually symbolizing, brethren, ladies and gentlemen, the joining of the merger of two families. And therefore, since there were no persons here who indicated any reason, just reason for these two not to be joined together, I now, as a marriage officer and a minister of the gospel, do take the opportunity to declare that these two, waiting for it, are now husband and wife. This, the Bible does indicate, what God has joined together, let no man put asunder. Let's bow our heads, please, as we pray. Father, we take this opportunity to thank you for being here with us in this marriage ceremony, this wedding ceremony. Of course, there is some joy, there is some concern, there may be some concerns. After all, these are, though adults, they are still children of their parents. And there might be some tugging at the heart from the families, because they love and they are concerned about their children. There's absolutely nothing wrong with that. I pray now, Father, though, that you'll minister to this new couple and that you'll aid us all who have been privileged to be here to also encourage the successful development of this relationship. May your will be done. Bless them. Help them to be able to manage conflicts. Yes, conflicts will come. Challenges will be there. But I pray, Father, that you will work things out, give them both wisdom, so that they may be able to manage things well. And when persons look on, when persons observe them going down the road or doing various things, they'll be able to say, certainly Jesus Christ abides there. Thank you, Father, for your blessing and your multiplied blessings in the future. Whatever you desire for them, may that be accomplished. May we here not place pressure on them. May they have their minds, their heads attuned to your leading. Because as human beings, sometimes we're so anxious, when you're going to get the first child or how many children? No. Help us, Father, to pray that they'll make the right decision when they should have children. And Father, may they excel as parents, if that is your will. Thank you, Father, in Jesus' name. Amen. Thank you very much. Wonderful meeting you all. Right, so this is the opportunity we have to do some signing. We're going to be doing some signing now. You all are concerned about the kiss and the ring, right? Not concerned about that? Okay, well, that's good. So let's just sign and then we'll finish up. Come right along.
Happiness was a tangible thing, it would be you. If you'd have told me the feeling you'd bring, I'd think it untrue. And people search for a wonder like you all of their lives. You still amaze me after all this time. You pull me in like some kind of wind, mesmerized by the hold I'm in. Leave you here, I wanna promise as one does. I will protect you at all costs, keep you safe here in my.
I'll never dream like I used to do. If someone tried to hurt you, I don't see how that could happen. I'd fight for you in ways you can't imagine. Felt this, no, I haven't. I hope it would be alright to stay right here beside you.
And promise as one does, I will protect you.
If you ever feel like a loss, I'll come.
precious than a rose. My girl, you're beautiful. Your soul is timeless, and your heart is made of gold. I'm glad I'm in your world. And if I could have my way, I would start every day waking up next to you, lady. And when the day is done and the sun goes down, with you I'd want to lay my head. Baby, if the rain starts to fall outside of your window, it's alright, cause I'm on the next side of your pillow. I spoke to God, and the signs he gave were clear. So will you marry me, baby? Marry me, girl, girl, with me.
If happiness was a tangible thing, it would be you. If you'd have told me the feeling you'd bring, I'd think it untrue. And people search for a wonder like you all of their lives. You still amaze me after all this time. You pull me in like some kind of wind, mesmerized by the hold I'm in. Leave you here, I don't wanna, I wanna. Promise as one does, I will protect you at all costs. Keep you safe here in my.
Try to, I'll never dream like I used to do. If someone tried to hurt you, I don't see how that could happen. I'd fight for you in ways you can't imagine. Felt this, no, I haven't. I hope it would be alright to stay right here beside you.
And promise as one does, I will protect you.
All right, so we... Right, thanks. There are some things that I've seen in marriages, weddings. It seems as though people wait for this moment. So here's what's going to happen. There are some persons who would want these two expressions or activities to take place very shortly. One involves metallic objects, you know, and there is nothing in a ring that secures your marriage, so we would not be blessing the ring. There are many rings that have been blessed and the marriage gone through. Right? So it's about blessing you all so that we pray God, you remain committed to one another. Okay? That's the important thing. And then there is something else that creates maybe more emotions. You know what I'm talking about? You all are big people, man. Come on. So, so we're getting to the rings now. So the person who has been given the responsibility of walking with expensive objects. Now, one of the things that we take into well, that was stressful. One of the things that in marriage you try not to do is to embarrass the other party. All right? So Kharyse, just in case Geovanni does not recall which finger to put it on, don't say you idiot to so and so. No. Don't let anybody know. But you just lift the finger nicely for him and your business fix. Because you're a team. You cover for one another. Right? If you don't cover for one another, mash up, you know. Cover for one another. You do embarrass one another. So let's go. Let's go. So you face one another and let's see how this is done. And all right, so there are some authorized photographers and cameramen here. Nice. Just one moment. Kharyse, how that was? No. The folk want to hear you. They like to hear this, you know, and know them. And know them well. How it was?
He nearly forgot, but he got it right at the last second.
That is the best you can say? Well, I'm glad he got it. All right? So you'll continue helping him along on the journey, right? Because he may not get it right all the time, right? Right, so help him out. Very well. So let's see. And now just before Geovanni, I want you to think about this because this is a very good opportunity. I'm almost sure you have a good opportunity now since you go in last to hit back. Right? But oh, you going for peace? Let's hear it.
I choose peace.
Well, you're a smart guy, because I've realized that you don't win against the wife, you know. So you're a smart guy. So let's see how this is done. Geovanni, how was you tying me up, man, with all this thing? How was this? How was it?
Good.
Lost his voice. My goodness. What did you do? You gave him an injection that caused problems. Okay, no problem. Well done. Okay, so here goes. No, keep facing each other. Now, this is the part that, you know, folk really want the cameramen, they assign the cameramen to get the shot, right? So we want you to put down your phones and cameras for now. No, I promise you. Where you from? Trinidad, right? Praise the Lord. Put on your phones. I promise you. Hold on. I promise you. So just listen up. I'm going to say something after this. And I'll, on your side. So hold on. Okay, so here we are. Proceed. You can't wait on anybody to tell you when to kiss your wife. All right. Hey. Easy. Easy. All right. So thank you. You guys good? You good, right? Right. Now, they really enjoyed that. They really enjoyed that. They enjoyed it so much that They enjoyed it so much that they want to do it again. This time, stop it. This time, for the persons who have their cameras out, you do your thing. So, that is your cousin? Okay. Yeah, well, he inside. He came all the way for this, huh? What? If you see that, leave that for later. Nah. All right. So, ladies and gentlemen, Kharyse gave Geovanni a promissory note just now, and I'm glad that you didn't get to see it. It would be all right. All right. Very well. Okay. So, just one moment. All right, we're almost through with our ceremony here. We have what is called, what again? Unity plant. This is the first time I'm seeing this one. Of course, you know, there's a unity candle and the sand and those types of things. But this is the first time I'm seeing this version. So I'm actually looking forward to seeing it. So, please, enjoy yourself. This is all about these two lives coming together and being merged, of course, in one purpose. And this is wonderful. This is a way that marriage will survive, relationships survive, and let's see how they do this. Thank you. You guys are doing a great job there. Thanks.
Here's my hand, it's yours to hold. I give myself to you.
Here's my heart, please make it yours. I give my love to you.
We are two becoming one. Here I am, here's all of me. You have all that once was mine.
And here's my promise, I'm yours to hold. I'll stay here by your side.
We are two. Join me not undone. May I love a Christ on display.
Candles eventually burn out, and sand eventually blows away. But plants, when grounded properly, are always here to stay.
My life, I lay it down. I give up myself for you.
The couple just informed me that the plant is a male and its name is Alfred. Well, today is not a day for me to disagree with them, so congratulations. your first child. Hold. Yes. Okay, so we're wrapping up now. There are a few things we wrap up. One of my very good friends, Gideon St. Bryce, said to me something that I'd repeat in every single wedding. There are many persons who do not obstruct. So all of us came here today. They're big people. They decided to get married. We're not getting in their way. And that's all right. But there's a missing element. Gideon St. Bryce said, we don't obstruct, but we don't help to construct. We don't obstruct, we take a passive approach. Let them run the thing. But when pressure comes, and one goes running home to complain about the other, are you going to sit down and listen and encourage it? Or are you going now to state, hear what? You all are married. I want to help you all. So I'm going to, both of you can come. We can talk about this thing. Or this is what you can do now. Go and do this, go back, but go back home. Do so and so and so. That is not something to apply if there is abuse inside there. I'm not telling you that. If there's abuse inside there, run. Get out of it, right? But I'm simply saying that we need to take the approach of helping to construct. So it is not obstructing and constructing. Okay? Well, I'd want you to turn around, face your audience, your public. So, I'm holding in my hand what some people call a deed. It indicates that these two belong to one another. Following me? What happens, what I've seen in most weddings, is that this document is given to the wife, the bride, by the marriage officer. I think that's inappropriate. The Bible says, the husband is the head of the home. And therefore, I should not bypass the husband. This document should really be given to the husband. And that's what I will do today. However, there's something that I have learned. I've learned this. And I think most of us will agree with this. Here's what I've learned. How careful are men with this? Who's more careful with this? The wife, not so? So we're going to test his wisdom. My duty is to give this to the man. But we're going to test his wisdom. And wisdom likely dictates that he, not me, he will give his wife. How do you like that? Yeah? So we're going to test that. We're going to test that out. Let's see. Man did that quickly. He learned fast, you know? he learned fast. All right? And that is good. So ladies and gentlemen, I'd want to just have us pray at this time, and then I will introduce this marvelous couple. Let's pray. Father, we are here We have witnessed this joining together, two hearts, two lives. We are thankful that they are here and that they have exhibited love, displayed love for one another. They've waited. One apparently waited longer than the other. But we are thankful that they have come together and determined that this is the time to have this ceremony. Now, be with them on this journey. In Jesus' name. Amen. Ladies and gentlemen, it is with joy I can introduce you to my friends, one from Jamaica, the other from Trinidad, a wonderful Caribbean blend. Eh? Yes, a wonderful Caribbean blend. What's that? A proper seasoning, yes. Ladies and gentlemen, please put your hands together for Mr. and Mrs. Giovanni Anthony John Keith.
We are made of each other, baby.